The newest Jurassic World installment is upon us like a hungry T-Rex, who doesn't have any feathers for some reason. Here's a few things Hollywood is still getting wrong about dinosaurs. Many dinosaurs had feathers, but the dinosaurs of Jurassic World are covered in scales, like crocodiles and lizards. They might have made an effort to stick in a few feathers on this dinosaur, but even if they did, that's not a real animal. It's a hybrid of two different species, which brings us to our next point. Genetics doesn't work that way.
What is that thing?
They made it.
This is the most dangerous creature that ever walked the earth.
Sure, some species can breed. That's how you get a liger. But the Indoraptor isn't like a liger. It's a mix of a type of tyrannosaur and raptor, two very different kinds of animals. It would be more like if you tried to breed a lion with a wolf instead. It's just not gonna happen. The DNA isn't compatible. Dinosaurs didn't roar. In the first Jurassic World, T-Rex's roar was made from a mix of animal sounds. And it sounds pretty similar in the new film. But dinosaurs didn't roar like a lion. They're related to birds, which means their voice box was probably similar to a bird's. Raptors had wings. First of all, raptor hands didn't droop down like that. In reality, that would only happen if their wrists were broken. In truth, raptors, like birds today, had wings. They couldn't fly, but the wing shape means their arms looked nothing like this. Dinosaurs were colorful. Yeah, Jurassic World's dinosaurs are way too dull. Sure, earth tones like green and brown are common in today's reptiles, but paleontologists have found that dinosaurs came in a kaleidoscope of bright colors, just like today's birds. Some even had shiny, iridescent feathers. We get it, Hollywood. T-Rex is scarier with its iconic roar. And velociraptors looked more vicious without those ridiculous feathers. But come on, you could at least add a little more color. Maybe next time.
It was all a lie!
This video was made in large part thanks to paleontologist Steve Brusati, author of The Rise and Fall of the Dinosaurs.